10-round main event, sanctioned and supervised by the New York State Athletic Commission, John Prenderville, chairman, ring officials for the main event. The judges, Artie Idala and Sam Irem. Your timekeeper is Fred Abatello. Referee for the main event is Arthur Mercanti.
Arthur Mercanti in the ring. He'll be the referee for the main event.
Introducing the principals in the corner to my left. He hails from Kiskelia in the Dominican Republic. Blue trunks, trimmed in white, 134¾ pounds. Here is Villamar Fernandez.
Fernandez from the Dominican Republic.
He hails from Managua, Nicaragua. He wears red trunks, 135¼ pounds. The junior lightweight champion of the world, devastating Alexis Arguello.
Alexis Arguello, the junior lightweight champion of the world, his title is not on the line tonight. He is fighting Wilmar Fernandez. Fernandez with a record of 21 wins, 6 losses, and 3 draws. He's got 7 knockouts. Arguello, 59 wins, 3 losses, and 49 of those 59 wins were by knockouts. He's knocked out 49 of the 59 opponents he's faced. He's a knockout puncher all the way. He's a junior lightweight. He's as tall as a middleweight. He is one of the best fighters in the world. He's fighting Wilmar Fernandez, one of the toughest little guys in the lightweight division. And look at the way he started off as Wilmar Fernandez on the left and Alexis Arguello on the right. Arthur McCann to the referee, round one of a 10-round bout. Arguello is acknowledged to be one of 3 or 4 of the best fighters in the world. No question about it. Now, Wilmar Fernandez, he will box as long as he can. If he gets hurt, he'll start slugging it out. And that would be the biggest mistake he could possibly make. He's that type of a fighter, though. He'll box as much as he can. The only possible chance that he has in a fight like this is to box all the way, if he can do it. But if he gets tagged, he's the type of fighter who will stand toe-to-toe, slug it out with you. And he cannot do that with Alexis Arguello, I assure you. Fernandez has fought some of the best in his division. Including the young man you just saw in the ring a little while ago, Edwin Fairway. Or Antonio Amaya, Ray Lunny, Ray Lampkin, Roberto Duran. He fought last year for the World Lightweight title, lost to him, but it went 13 rounds. Fernandez got knocked out, but after the fight, Duran said, "My whole body hurts from that little guy. He can really hit." 13 rounds with the champion. Now he's in there against Arguello. Arguello has ideas of fighting Duran for the lightweight title. 1 minute to go in round one. He wants to fight Duran perhaps in the early part of next year for the lightweight title. He's already won the featherweight title. He owns the junior lightweight title now. And the only other thing he wants out of life is the junior is the lightweight title. The full-fledged lightweight title. Good boxer, good puncher, excellent puncher. Seconds, round one. Left hook. Pretty good punch by Wilmar Fernandez. Fernandez is a smart fighter. He'll tie him up as much as he can. And I'm sure that they told him he's got to box him to win. He's got to box him and stay away and try to get his points in from outside. The end of round one. That's Alexis Arguello. We're looking at 135 and a quarter pounds. He's 26 years old, and he's 5 feet 9 inches. He's very, very tall for a junior lightweight. He's the junior lightweight champion of the world right now. He won the title, incidentally, from Alfredo Escalera, when you saw in the first 10-rounder tonight. And he is also the former featherweight champion. He gave up the featherweight title because he couldn't get enough action in it. He ran out of opponents. Actually, what he did was knock everybody out. There was nobody left to fight, and he was thinking seriously of retiring from boxing rather than fight anymore. But along came a man by the name of Dr. Edward Roman, talked him into it, and here he is back in action. Round two. Arguello on the right, Fernandez. No, he's on the right. Okay, off the head is the referee. Second round of a 10-rounder. Man, Villamar is starting to slug, and this is what I meant before. He could be making the mistake of his life right now. But the crowd here likes it at Madison Square Garden. And Fernandez is that type of a fighter. I think he'll box as long as he wants to, I guess. But there are times when he likes to mix it up. And you cannot do that without paying the price. I guess not, well. Whale has all the advantages. He's got the reach, he's got the height, he's got the punch. He's got the experience. Just taking his time, Arguello. He trained hard for this fight. He didn't take it easy. In spite of the fact it's not a title fight, he says, I train for every fight like it's a title fight. Everyone is important. He's looking to fight Roberto Duran, so he wants to look impressive, especially here in Madison Square Garden, especially before as many people are looking in tonight, such as you. He wants to be impressive because he wants that lightweight title. And this is the place to do it. 1 minute to go in the second round. Arguello does not waste any punches. Bides his time. When he jabs, it's a soft jab. Just lays the left hand out. Was that Fernandez? Actually, what he's doing is keeping Fernandez from throwing a punch by doing that. Nothing stiff about the jab. Not now. Can be. Good exchange by Fernandez. A good left hook by Fernandez. A soft right hand, but the left hook landed. Good punch by Villamar Fernandez. And as Fernandez now is taking the lead, at 15 seconds to go in the round. That's the end of round two. Arguello on the right, and Fernandez on the left. mistake about it. Little Willemar Fernandez is a tough little competitor. Knows how to fight. He's got a lot of experience. If he could take some pot shots at Alexis Barbaro all night and try to box him, that's his chance. That's his big chance in this fight. Well, much more experienced. Good right hand by Willemar Fernandez. The right hand is stung, not well. He's complaining to the referee about something, I don't know what. Pretty good move by Fernandez. That's what he's got to do. He's got to do that all night long. And in between moves like that, he's got to try to get some shots in there, of course. But this is the type of fight that he has to fight in order to win. Cuello is just taking his time. Very cool, very sure of himself. Fernandez is pretty popular in New York. There's a lot of fans here tonight. You can tell every move he makes, any good move, they cheer for him. Right hand by Fernandez. He's getting some pretty good licks in there right now. A minute to go in the third round. He's throwing sneaky punches. And whoever was advising him was telling him good. Just don't get careless, Willemar, because it'll be your undoing when you do. Stand still and you're in trouble. Move and you're all right, Willemar Fernandez. Fernandez again. He's getting those sneaky shots in there. I don't know that he might be taking this round, and I think he took the second round. That's the end of round three. This fight is an exclusive presentation of the UA Columbia Madison Square Garden Cable Television Sports Network. And the fans here at Madison Square Garden like this one. They like what Willemar Fernandez is doing. He's staying outside. He's moving from side to side. He's taking a shot at Alexis Arguello whenever he gets the chance. He's landing with him. And as I said before, I don't know that he might have taken that second or third round. There he is. Little Willemar Fernandez from Santo Domingo. 21 wins, 6 losses and 3 draws, but only 7 knockouts. Tough young man. I just heard he fights like a lion. Arguello on the right, Fernandez on the left. 10-round bout. A lot of people didn't think this fight would go this long. Some have said 2 or 3 rounds. They know the punching power of Alexis Arguello, but Fernandez is doing what he has to do to survive. As I said, he's moving. Punching and moving, slipping. Get your licks in and get out of trouble. That's his MO at the moment. Arguello's looking to throw a big one. Arguello's jabs are soft. Just pawing at Fernandez. Now snapping the jab. Snapped the lead at that time. Just pawing it. he's got to do. Good move by Fernandez. Went around for him at the end of the bout. The dressing room, he said that 1 minute ago, he said that Fernandez is a tough guy to fight. It's really a pain in the neck to fight, is the way he put it. And you can see why. He moves on you and he doesn't give you any kind of a target. Larry Stanton fought Fernandez. Said he was almost impossible to hit in the head. Well, he was almost impossible to hit in the head for Stanton. Let's see how Arguello was. Stanton fought a draw with Guillermo Fernandez. That's it, the end of round four. Looking to get in the big punch, that's what he's doing. He's just following Fernandez around the ring, and every once in a while, Fernandez is getting the licks in, and Arguello is missing with that left hand. As I said earlier, Stanton said that it's almost impossible to hit Fernandez in the head, and Arguello is finding that out. Last punch of the last round, the left hook, a good one, but it went completely over the head. Arguello is just stalking him. He goes, snapped it off again. 3, 4, 5 good jabs by Fernandez. There's a lot of force behind it. Arguello took it. It was a good punch. Best punch he's thrown so far. Best punch of the fight. 1 minute to go. Round five. Another right hand by Fernandez. Two good hands. Left and a right by Fernandez. Right hand by Fernandez. He's really, really fighting now. He's fighting a real smart fight. He's punching and moving. And there's the elusive head again. Arguello just cannot find it. Aguero's got to be wondering what he's got in front of him right now. I don't think he ever figured this young man could fight as well as he does. He's no target. He gives Aguero no target at all. He hasn't hurt him. He hasn't landed a good punch on him so far in the five rounds. Good right hand. And Hernandez landed a right hand just at the bell. There he is, little Wilmar Fernandez, and he is really fighting a fight. I'd have to have him in front. I mean, he's if I were keeping the scorecard, I'd have to have him in front right now. He's made the fight. He's got the better punches across. And we are now coming into the sixth round, and I would have to give him the fight up to now. It's a 10-round fight, of course, and a lot can happen in the next five rounds. But Wilmar Fernandez is fighting the smartest fight I've ever seen a fight here in Madison Square Garden, at least. And he's doing exactly what he has to do. He's moving, he's getting his punches in whenever he can. He's getting punches in and snatches, and then he's moving away. Every punch he gets out of trouble. Boxing very well. Round six. Aguero on the right. Fernandez on the left. And Fernandez is a big surprise to a lot of people here in Madison Square Garden tonight, I'm sure. Fernandez can pull this one out. It'll be one of the biggest upsets in boxing in recent years, I'll tell you that. No way did he have a chance, did anybody give a chance to win this fight. I would have to have him head on points right now. The right hand, dropped in the right hand, Fernandez did. You can understand now why Fernandez went 13 rounds with Duran. He's a good little fighter. Hey, caught a right hand. That's the best punch that Aguero has thrown so far. He senses that he might have hurt him with it. And Aguero's coming on now. And he's punching. He's getting flicks in now. Both hands. And Fernandez has stopped moving. He's got to move out of there. He's in real trouble. Aguero, a barrage of punches. He hurt him with one. Followed up with a barrage of punches, and that Fernandez in a little bit of trouble for a while. Ties him up, the smart thing to do. No marks, he's not hurt now, he looks all right. But he took a barrage of punches from Aguero, the best flurry of the fight so far by Aguero. He sensed that he had Fernandez hurt. 1 minute to go in the sixth round. Is doing exactly what he has to do if he is hurt. He's moving around. He's not trying any sort of an offense. He's just staying out of trouble. All he's got to do is trying to survive the round. And Aguero's coming on now. He's catching him. He caught him with two good left hands to the head that time. From the close. And Aguero finding the mark a little bit now. There's another one. To the body and the head. Watch Aguero go to work. The round is almost over. That's it. The end of round six. Well, that's what they came to see. That's the Alexis Aguero that they came to see. Easily his best round of the fight so far. He sensed that he had Fernandez hurt about the middle part of the round, and he went on a barrage of punches. He had Fernandez in just a little bit of trouble. Here's another look at some of the action right now. Aguero now figures he's got Fernandez hurt, and he's really going to work. That's a real good left hand to the midsection. Doesn't miss another one. Those body punches really hurt. And they're going to show up. They're going to show up right away. They'll show up in a round or two. He's not missing any punches at all. Okay. Here we go with round seven. Alexis Arguello and Omar Fernandez. Arguello went right. And that last round was the best round of the fight so far. And Arguello is starting to pour it out. Up to that round, Fernandez was doing very, very well. Could easily have been ahead on some of the scorecards, if not all of them. Arguello's trying to do now is cut down the ring on Fernandez. Fernandez is moving around the ring, using up almost all of the ring, but Arguello's trying to cut the ring off on him. Keep him in one spot, preferably in the corner. He's got him now. That's what he's doing. He's doing it very well, too. Watch him maneuver Fernandez and cut down the ring on him. Cut down the ring, I mean, not give him too much punching room, not too much room to dance or move around. He's maneuvering him very well. In the meantime, he's catching some left jabs by Fernandez. There's a lot more power in Arguello's punches than there is in Fernandez's. Fernandez lands them, the power is not there. But when Arguello lands them, they hurt. This body punch is another right hand to the body. Brought with the left hook coming in. And then the right hand to the body. There's 1 minute to go in round seven. Seconds. Flurry to the body didn't mean much. Not much power in any of those points. Just a few attacks. Ten seconds to go in the round. Last seven. And Fernandez might be stealing this round. That's the end of round seven. I don't know. How's your scorecard? Arguello had one big round. He's looking to knock out Guillermo Fernandez. In the meantime, Fernandez is boxing him very well. He's getting his punches in there. He can survive if he can stay out of trouble and stay away from the big punch. He might easily win this fight. There are 11,875 people here in Madison Square Garden tonight. We're enjoying this one. I hope you are too. Say hello to all our friends out around the country: California, Alaska, Louisiana, some of our friends close by in Suffolk County and North Jersey. Nice to have you. We hope you're enjoying the fights from Madison Square Garden. This is John Condon, and I'm happy to bring them to you. Okay, round eight. And whoever thought it would go eight rounds? Nobody, I can tell you, who considers themselves even half of an expert thought that Guillermo Fernandez could go eight rounds with a puncher like Alexis Arguello. But he's done a masterful job. All the way through, except for one round. Got himself hurt a little bit, but he survived. Arguello's really going to have to go out now. He's got less than three rounds to do the job. He's going to win by knockout, he's got to do a lot of work on Fernandez because Fernandez is not hurt. No marks, nothing. Still fighting a very smart fight. He's moving, punching when he can, staying out of trouble. Says, come on, let's do a little fighting, but that's not exactly what Fernandez has in mind. He's not going to stand in there and punch toe-to-toe with Arguello, not in a million years. He's fighting the kind of fight he has to fight to win. Arguello is getting a little bit exasperated. He's losing his cool just a little bit. To go in the eighth round. Oh, getting a little Ali. He caught a right hand in the process. He's fighting Arguello now, but he's moving. And he is a very, very elusive target. Arguello's finding that out. Seconds, round eight. 10 seconds. Right hand by Fernandez, a real good right hand. Now he's fighting Arguello and beating him to the punch at the end of the round. He was fighting Arguello and beating him to the punch. I will tell you, that little kid is really putting on a fight. He fought Arguello on his own game, beat him to the punch. He stood and slugged with him. The crowd here at Madison Square Garden was wild about it. It's something that he should not have done, but he did it and he won by it. He beat Arguello to the punch, and as I said before, this pesky little kid, Guillermo Fernandez, has got to have Alexis Arguello bothered somebody. Arguello cannot get the big punch across. As Harry Stanton said, the head of Guillermo Fernandez is a very elusive target, and every time that Arguello even throws a jab at it, it's not there. He surprised a lot of people, I'll tell you that. He's got a lot of fans here. Here we go, round nine. Arguello on the right, Fernandez on the left. Ninth round of a 10-round fight. Referee is Arthur McCanty. Caught the tail end of that hook. Damage, but Fernandez's fans love it. Up to now, Fernandez is fighting a perfect fight for an opponent such as Alexis Arguello. Doing what he has to do. Got a pretty good stiff left hand that time. And it hurt him a little bit. Arguello's trying to sucker him in. He's got his left hand down low. He's trying to sucker Fernandez in. He wants him to slug with him. trying to get him in there. He's holding that left hand down low, hoping to mend, thinking that his jaw is a target, but Fernandez won't fall for it. He won't go for it. Took a punch shot out at that time. There goes the left hand. Is up again now. 1 minute to go in the ninth round. Exciting as it is here tonight. This is really a fight that was unexpected. Nobody expected little Philomar Fernandez to go 10 rounds with a great puncher like Alexis Arguello. Here we go, the 10th and final round. Referee McCanty has them shake hands, and here we go. Fernandez has got to survive this round. Arguello knows he's lost some prestige so far in the fight. Just move and stay out of trouble. That's what Fernandez has to do. Arguello looking to put the big one across. He wants to knock out Fernandez. He hasn't got too much time left to do it. Great puncher, 49 knockouts of 59 opponents. More experience, a world champion, and little Villamar Fernandez is giving him a boxing lesson right now with that left jab. Fernandez getting just a little bit tired. He's done a lot of running, he's done a lot of moving tonight. And he caught a real good left hook, and Arguello knows he's got him hurt a little bit. Fernandez is hurt a little bit, and he's going to have to move out of there. And now he's taking a little bit of punch from more than he took at any time during the fight. When he's able to move, his legs are in good shape. He's got to move and stay out of there. Now he's catching him. And he with a pretty good right hand of his own. Went into the body by Arguello. Arguello is trying to get a series of punches going. But Fernandez is picking on, most of it. Fernandez is standing still now, which is a mistake. He can catch it if he stands there. He's got to move out of there. 1 minute to go in the round, the 10th and final round. Arguello's getting him in now. Fernandez has got to go, he's got to move. There's 45 seconds left in the round. Fernandez has got to move. Arguello is looking to put the big one over. Fernandez has got to move out of there. 35 seconds. Comes over the flurry. 25 seconds. Bear should be going in after him, and he's not doing it. He caught him with a right hand, a good right hand. And look at that little tremendous fight. Hook, a whale with a right hand. Throws another one, punches to the body by Fernandez. And he finishes the bout in a flurry of punches to a whale. Nobody expected the bout to go 10 rounds. Look at that little Villamar Fernandez. Who's to say he could not win the fight? It's going to be an interesting decision. Whoever thought that that little guy right there would go 10 rounds with Alexis Arguello, the world junior lightweight champion. Fernando has knocked out 49 out of 59 opponents. Fernando is regarded as one of the greatest fighters in the world. And this little kid, Villamar Fernandez, from Santo Domingo, went all the way with him, did a marvelous job, and I'm going to be really, really anxious to hear the decision on this one. We're waiting for the decision now. Jackie Lee, the ring announcer, is going around the ring picking up the judges. The judges are Artie Idala and Sam Irem, and the referee is Arthur McKenzie. And all three partake in the decision. There's Villamar Fernandez. His hand was hovering up in the air. They think he won the fight. I wonder what the judges think. We have a lot of security around the ringside. There's a lot of special police up on the apron of the ring. The Tigers are up there. They're all anxiously awaiting this decision. Villamar Fernandez. Win or lose, a great fight. Even if it's a draw, a great fight, Villamar. You did a Ricky Lee with the decision. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the decision by the judges and the referee. Judge Sam Irem scores the fight. 6 rounds, Fernandez. 4 rounds, Arguello. Referee Arthur Mercanti scores 5 rounds, Arguello. 5 rounds, Fernandez.
Here's the big one. 6-4 and 5-5.
Artie Idala scores the fight 5-4, one even, favor of Villamar Fernandez.
And this is the winner.
The winner by majority decision.
Villamar Fernandez. And we'll be back with the wrap up in just a moment.